Oh, you don't like any chopstick at all.
This thing got lost.
You've got one life to live. Hi guys, welcome back to another video. Today is a Saturday and it's a beautiful day. We're heading somewhere and we're going to be almost out all day. So
yeah, we are going to be out all day.
Yeah, we're going to be out all
day. Until about 10:30, 11 o'clock, and we were yesterday too.
Yeah, so we didn't really have time to record a video that we really wanted to record in. That we should just do this in the car while driving down.
Because we don't really have an opportunity to sit down on the couch and set everything up and record, so we just use our little thing that goes on the window. And it's if it's a little bumpy, we're sorry, but it's kind of like spur of the moment. I was like, you know, let's just take them with us. Cause
okay, the title of today's video is going to be about our unpopular opinions about what is going on in the society concerning race, police, you know, stuff like that. So let's get this video started.
The purpose of this video is just to give our opinion. So I feel like, you know, the race tension in our country has gotten out of hand. I feel like, and this, I know that I'm a white man, so I'll never understand or know what it's like to live in a black man's shoes. But what I can say is that anybody can hate. They don't have to be white or black. Anybody can hate. And that's what everything boils down to. It's not, racism is just hatred. You know, and there's extreme expressions of hatred and there's less extreme expressions of hatred, you know. Somebody could be blatantly racist and call you a racist name or say something racist towards you. Or somebody can be, you know, an undercover racist, and you know, they may not say anything, but their actions prove otherwise, such as, you know, saying that a seat's taken when it's really not because they don't want you to sit beside them. You know, and you won't understand that, or you won't know that, because you don't know somebody's intentions, you don't know the truth behind a lie.
Yeah.
If you can't, you know, how are you gonna know that somebody's sitting there, you know? Because at that moment in time, you're taking somebody for their word. But the only way that you can overcome that is to understand that it's everywhere and it's been here since the beginning of time.
Yeah.
You know, and the only way that you can defeat that is not let it get to you. By meaning, knowing who you are and who God made you to be, and understanding that not everyone's like that, and
he's an express lane.
I keep getting in this express lane.
Yeah,
guys. Sorry.
Keep getting this express lane, baby.
But understanding that not everyone's like that, and there will come a time where that person who is acting in that way or saying those things will be judged by what they've said and what they've done. And you're not their final judge, so you can't judge them upon that. It may get to you. You may be angry for a second, but you can't let it fester inside of you, and you can't let it control your emotions, because if you do that, then they win.
Yeah. I feel like, you know, me personally, the way I feel about the thing, the situation, it's like, yeah, it hurt. You know, it hurt. At that moment, you want to, like, you want to punch somebody in the face. You want to curse them out. You know, that's what you're thinking.
Yeah.
That's what you want to do. You want to, like, do something bad back to that person. But I don't think that will help you, because you need to act different. Because I feel you will be more of, you'll be more in standard.
Held to a higher standard.
Yeah. Then if you act back the same thing, if somebody did something to you and you did the same thing back to them.
So what you're saying is hold yourself to a higher standard.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
It will not make no, because you have to be different. That's what I'm trying to say. Like, instead, if you were like, you took it in a different way by just ignoring them, or, you know, just ignoring them, that's the highest I can say. That would make you be different. Like, oh my gosh, if they were thinking they were better than you, but they would be like, I thought I was better than you, but the way they took this, they will be the one to feel that shame.
Or somebody else outside of the situation will see that. Well, yeah. And you may be a light to them.
Exactly.
And another thing is, a lot of times, me personally, I thank God that I was born in the time that I was born in. You know, because although it's still exists and it will always and forever exist until Christ comes back and redeems the world.
We cannot change history, but we can try, you know, on working on the future.
The good thing is think about it like this. Be thankful that you don't live in a time where those types of things, especially in the history of America, where, you know, black people were being treated the way that they were treated.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I thank God that I don't live in that time, so I don't, A, have to see it, and B, be a part of that. You know, because I don't, me personally, I always think, like, I don't know what I would have done in a time where, you know, you only have choice decisions because, you know, you can't, back then you couldn't get away with anything.
Yeah.
You know, even if you're a white man helping out a black person back then, you would still be found and either punished or tortured for what you did. And
it's
so
crazy.
I thank God a lot of times that I'm not in that situation, so I don't have to live in that environment. Now, I think also that you have to understand that, you know, unfortunately, guys, you know, that's the way the world is. That's the way the world is.
Like,
so you're going to either let it step all over you and crumble you, or you're going to stand up on your 10 toes and you're going to overcome it.
Yeah. You know, I'm not saying it's easy for us to find a solution for this, but I feel like if it could be any person, I'm not just saying this, it could be from a white person or even in between, it's just color, but we're going to still be saying in between a white and black, we're still going to be saying that. But even just within the black people, you know.
Sorry guys, they're doing road work right here, so. There's a lot more bumps right here.
There are still some people who still look at, there are still some black people who still look at black people like they are not up to what they are. And there are still some white people who still look at white people that they are not up to what they are. And I'm like, okay, what are we doing? You know?
Yeah, and the thing about it is, you know, I know, like, a lot of my friends and my family, you know, are either African or Black American. And
you say a lot of your friends and family? Okay.
And yeah, my friends and you're my family.
I know, that's what I said, okay.
So, you know, people, especially in America, don't understand that, you know, I wouldn't say most, but some people don't understand that, you know, it's not just here in America, you know. She's from, you know, it's, I don't know, is it like that where you're from, like lighter skin versus darker skin?
It's like, not like that, but for me, the way I'm saying this is somebody could give you a hate because of how you are with your skin too, even though you're in the same skin tone like them. But maybe you say you were really like darker, like really darker than them, or maybe you were really lighter than them.
Yeah.
You know, people always say these things, but I feel like the only reason why is the way it is between a black and white person is because of history. And what we're trying to say here is we can't let that determine the future of how we're going to live our lives. We can't let it be like that.
Yeah.
Even though, even now in the present days to now, we still have people who still treat people in that way, who still look at things in that way. Now, how can we change them from looking? How can we change them from looking at things in that way? It's from us on how we treat people around us, or when they treat, when they say something racist to us, the way we respond to it.
Yeah.
That's where some people will not learn, but one day it might click in somebody's mind to realize what they are doing. Cause like we all are the same. We are the same thing. We came from the same God. I don't know why all this is happening, but the world is evil. You know.
And then also, I think you were talking about, see, this conversation, this topic came up because we were talking about it the other night, and we decided we wanted to record a video on it, so we chose today and this time. But also the other night you were talking about
I'm sorry.
Yes, I will. I'm just trying to get there as quickly as I can, babe. That's why I'm standing over in the fast lane.
Oh, okay. What?
You were also talking about loving like your hair and
Oh yeah, okay.
Your example of your colleague at work.
I was going to say this, like before I came here, I know where I come from, there's not many white people for me to know all this, but as I said earlier, even in between just Africans or in between just black people.
Sorry guys about these bumps.
Or even in, you know, in between just Africans or in between just, you know, black people, there's always still that hate, because all this race something is just hatred. That's what I would say.
Yeah.
And then there's also history behind.
Jealousy or envy,
yeah, and it, there's also history behind it. That's why it's so strong, because there's history behind it. But when I came here, that's when I realized like how much people are so uncomfortable with like their skin color, their hair and stuff like that. And one time I asked somebody and they're like, it's because of how like white people tend to treat them. And I'm like, right, like about their hair.
About their hair?
Yeah, maybe like in school, the
what
they would say.
Like?
Curly, like you know how we black people, we have curly full hair. And to me, that's the most amazing thing that ever happened. I don't even know why anybody feels bad for that. But if somebody was to say anything, me, I love my hair, I love everything about me, my color, everything, I accept it and I love it so much. But when I came here, I just realized how much people are like, it's so difficult for somebody to accept that. Somebody was really like down with it. And as I said, when I asked and I came to realize that that's why they felt that way, what I said was, why are you even letting that get to you? Like, why?
Yeah.
Your color is the best thing that ever happened to you. You need to realize it, accept it, and take it. Stop. You're the one letting this. Like, when you let somebody walk up on you, they will walk and do whatever they want to do on you. That's it. If I say something and the way you take it, it will make me go further. But if you respond in a way like just ignore me or whatever, trust me, I'm not going to do that again. I wouldn't. Right,
yeah,
baby?
You're right.
That's for me, that's really how I feel. And I feel like we need to stop. When I say we, I'm not trying to do this as a separation. I'm still also
as
going to go.
Yeah. Whole, yeah.
Yeah, I'm saying everyone as a whole.
Black,
but when
white,
black, white, we need
Asian,
to.
Every race.
Because even with the white people or Hispanic, whatever race, people also still have that, you know, where they feel like this or that, you know. But we need to accept the way we are. We need to really start loving ourselves and accepting
video,
the way we are.
I seen a video on YouTube where, you know, this black man was talking to this other black man about, you know, racism. He was like, give me an example of, you know, you being discriminated against. And the black man was like, I went to apply for a job, and during my interview, they gave him the job, and he accepted, and they said, before you start work, you'll have to cut your hair. And the black guy said, that was discrimination. Why do I need to cut my hair? This is my natural hair.
Mm-hmm.
I've had a job where they've asked me to cut my, when I had long hair, back when I had long hair, I was asked to cut my hair. Because some, you know, everything isn't racist, like, or discrimination. Like, professional places, they want you to look professional. They want you, like, the clean buzz cut that I have. Some places want you to look like that,
and some people,
because
some
that's
don't
that's
care
what they consider professional. White, black, Hispanic, Asian, they don't
matter.
Want you to have long ponytail hair. You know, as a lawyer, you see most lawyers, they don't have long ponytails, white or black. So if you're going to work for a law firm and you're black or white and they ask you to cut your hair, That's not discrimination.
Yeah.
That's just what that law firm deems professional.
Yeah.
You know, so.
That's true.
You can't blame everything or cop everything out to it's because I'm white or it's because I'm black or it's because I'm this, because everything's not that way. It's just the way that some people decide that they want things done.
It's like sometimes you can't joke in a certain way because you're this kind of skin color. And when you sound like that, somebody will look at you, it's all about you being racist against me. Or if I joke in a certain way with you, you'll be like, you're being like that with me because I'm white. Like, it's not, that's not the reason. I'm just, it's just a joke. And if you took it that way, I'm sorry that you're taking it that way, but I didn't mean like that. But am I saying people should go off calling people names? No, I feel like it shouldn't even, like, I feel like it shouldn't even be called. Those names should not even be called.
Yeah.
It's not something, it's not a joke. It's something that was really not a good memory about. So why are we even using it? It wasn't. So if it's not that good, we should just respect it by letting it go.
Like, it's a difference between calling you a chocolate woman and, you know, a colored woman. You know what I'm saying?
It's simple. It's color. It's just a color. Well,
the thing is somebody may be like, that white man called me chocolate. That's racist. But really, he might be admiring your skin tone. You know?
Somebody will take it like that.
And that gets into another thing. When we talk about people getting offended by everything, this society and this world, the way it is nowadays, social media was the best and worst thing to happen to people, because everybody in this society and in this world these days wears their emotions on their sleeve. You can't say one sip. It frustrates me. A lot of times I close my mouth and I bite my tongue and don't engage in discussions, because me, I'm the type of person, I can be open, honest, and raw with you about my opinion on a situation. And you can be open and honest and raw with me about your opinion on the same situation, and one be left and one be right, but I can agree to disagree and we can still be friends and move forward from it. But a lot of people can't do that. A lot of people get offended and they feel like you're disrespecting them and you don't love them and you don't want anything to do with them, which is not the case. I can agree to disagree and think that you're a bold-faced wrong, but still be your friend and love you. But everybody can't do that, because everybody wears their emotions on their sleeve. And it's gotten to a point to where, like, you know, you have to cross your T's and dot your I's before you say anything to anyone these days. And sometimes, you know, that's why me and my wife, we don't have really that many friends, because, like I said in our last video, because sometimes I have to humble myself and go apologize to people so that, you know, because it's the right thing to do. Because if I hurt somebody's feelings, I don't want them to have their feelings hurt. I don't want them to feel like I'm just this mean, disrespectful person, because I'm not.
Yeah.
You know, but that's my opinion, and I will apologize if I offended you, but I will not apologize for the way I believe.
Yeah. So, and,
But that's a totally different topic, so let's get back on the open.
Yeah, you went really deep. So, and also, when my husband was talking about, like, the job part, I feel like me, okay, I work with all other kind of people. I'm specifically, if you were asking, I'm African. I work with Black American.
Really?
I work. What?
You're African?
Why you saying really? I'm African. Hey, what kind of a joke is that? Oh my gosh. You can't joke like that with me. Well, when you ask me, really, I'm African? Yeah, I'm African. I'm like.
Abai.
Yeah. I work with all kinds of people. And me, I'm that one person that I can deal with everybody in the room and with every kind of personality. My husband knows already. Every kind. I would joke, laugh. I would take you just the way you come and we'll deal with that. But sometimes people will say, oh, I'm saying this most. Some people will say, oh, I have to work as, you know, I have to work as hard. Babe, like, you know what people say? Like, they have to work double hard.
Yeah, they have to work twice as hard.
Okay, like, you hear a Black person say they'll have to work twice as hard to, you know, to prove themselves. They'll have to work twice as hard to prove themselves. And I've also have my aunt, like, my aunt that work out here, she have said that to me too. And it's true. It's true. It's not a lie.
I was going
to
say, that is true in a lot of cases.
It is true in a lot of cases. But I feel like we should not take it as if, we should not take it in a bad way.
Because you don't work for man, you work for God. It says that.
Yeah, we should not, exactly. We should not take, that's how we feel about it. We should not take it in a bad way. Like me, when I go to work and I'm doing my job, if you ask at my job, they will tell you, I'm the best, period, and all that. I give them my best. When they teach me I should do something like this and like that, I give them the best I can give them. I'm not doing it because I'm trying to impress them or whatever. No, I'm not doing it for that. That's just...
This ex is bumping, isn't it?
Yeah, babe.
But you are the best at your job. You know, you always...
When I'm doing something, I want to do it...
Because you work. You take pride in your work.
Really good. I'm not doing it for nobody.
You take pride in your work.
Yeah, I'm not doing it because I'm doing... I'm working so hard for them to see me or whatever. But if I feel like I do this, if you tell me, look, if you didn't do it like this, this is what you deserve for it, and you don't give me what I deserve, yes, I will ask for it.
It's just like this, you know. My last name, my dad's last name that he's given to me, you know, I represent that. So when I do a job, if I tell them my last name's Kite and they know my father, I represent my father by the work that I do. So I always take pride in the way I do my work because I don't want my dad's name to be slandered by somebody because they think I did a horrible job, because I'm not my dad, but I do wear his name. So I say that to say this. You're black, so you represent black people. So you take pride in your work. You do all these things because if you don't, guess what they're going to say about black people? Not just Rosme, but they're going to say Rosme and black people.
Yeah, because I don't want us. I don't want us to feel like we work double hard. We are not working to impress nobody.
I gotta use the bathroom, so I gotta stop by quick. Race shirt real quick, guys.
Okay. I don't want us to feel like we're impressing anybody. We are not. We are just doing our job. And when they give you a job, stop being lazy. Work. Do your job. Don't look at any other person. It goes same with like when you want to say if I was about to apply here, no, they will not take him because I'm black, and if he applied, they will take him because he's white. That also goes around with if you don't have a godfather. What I mean by godfather, like if you want a certain position of job, say working in, you know, a certain position, and you don't have somebody that you know, trust me, you might not get that job even if you have the qualifications. It happens everywhere.
Yeah.
Everywhere. It's not just about all because you're black or because you're white. It happens everywhere. But people just will base it, oh, it's because he's white and I'm black. No, it's not. And I will go back to also say this. If something is yours, no matter what, you will always have it. My mom have always told me this. Your destiny can be delayed but if it's yours, it will forever be yours. I was going to say, we are just saying this based, we are just giving our own opinions on how we think and feel about these things. We are not trying to, nobody should take it in a certain way out there. You guys should not take it in any kind of way. We're really just being open and saying how we feel and see things. So we hope you guys just take it in a positive way. And you know, it will be useful to somebody somewhere with an open heart. Yeah. And as my husband said, we thank you guys for being with us on this. You know, it was not boring at all. Been talking with you guys and doing this.
Yeah.
And now we are almost there, and we'll see you guys in our next video. We love you guys.
Peace.
Bye. Why did I do kisses? We love you guys. Babe.
Peace.
Oh, by the way, I wanted to say this. You guys acting about...
It's driving me crazy.
You guys were acting... you guys always kind of... compliment?
I have this song I want to listen to, but I don't want to get copyrighted, so I'm waiting for her to be quiet. But it's saying...
Yeah,
so.
Wait. You guys were asking about my... You guys have been commenting really good on my makeup. So, do you guys really want to see how I get all my looks? Because, you know, I can
maybe
do
she'll start her own YouTube channel doing makeup.
So, I can start something little somewhere.
And stuff. So, y'all guys comment and let her know what you guys think, okay?
Yeah, my husband already know what I wanted to say. Yeah. So, he wants to say it first for me so we can peace out of this place.
Listen to some musical. Bye-bye, guys.
Love you all.